Hello and welcome to Tech Deals. NVIDIA's GeForce GTX 1080 Ti top-end $700 graphics card. What is this? Who should watch this video? And should you buy this card? I'm going to talk about all those things in this video. Now, there are three different primary monitor resolutions available on the market today: 1080p, 1440p, and 4K. There are also some people who run multiple monitors. We will talk about all this. We'll talk about what kind of games, how this compares to the lower-end graphics cards currently available in the market, and whether or not you should consider AMD's upcoming Vega graphics card. Now, this video is a review of the 1080 Ti in general, not necessarily this specific card. I've previously done a video, which 1080 Ti should you buy? Link to that video in the video description below. In there, I talk about the different coolers, the different manufacturers, and the pros and cons. This video was meant to address the question, should you buy a 1080 Ti at all? Here's the reality. The performance difference between the slowest and the fastest 1080 Ti in the market is no more than about 5%. And the slower cards can generally be manually overclocked to match the higher cards. You don't buy them based on performance. Watch that video if you really want to know about all the differences. In this video, instead, I'm more going to be talking about the differences between the 1080 Ti and other cards in the market and what the benefits of spending $700 or thereabouts on a graphics card are. Now, first up, let me be very clear. If you simply want to play current modern games at 1080p resolution with an average of 60 frames per second at high detail, you don't need buy this card. This is overkill for that objective. A GTX 1060 or 1070, depending upon how much future-proofing you want in your card, will do that just fine. This is a premium card for a premium gaming experience. Now, what does that mean? Quite simply, 4K gaming first and foremost. Now, we'll talk about the other resolutions in a minute, but if you want to play games at 4K resolution, at high detail or better in 2017, you've come to the right place. This card is what you will need. I have tested games on the card beneath this, the GTX 1080, and it really struggles at 4K. This is notably faster than the 1080. Even though it's only a 1080 Ti, it is a solid 35 to 40% faster than a 1080, and it really shows in the performance. So if 4K gaming is on your list, this is what you need. Now, putting aside 4K gaming, let's talk about 1440p for a minute. There are actually two different 1440p resolutions worth talking about: ultrawide and standard. Standard is your standard 16:9 television-shaped screen, which has 3.6 million pixels on it. This is a good card for that, maybe a little bit overkill, but a very good card for that. At 3.6 million pixels, it's not quite double 1080p resolution. If you want to play the latest and greatest games, Ghost Recon Wildland comes to mind, it's very demanding, and you want to play them at 1440p, and you want to play them at maybe high or very high detail with a really good frame rate, you might need this card. The other 1440p resolution we're talking about is ultra-wide. It's the Ultra 21:9 ultra-wide screen monitors. Those have 5 million pixels. It's 1.4 million more than a standard 1440p, and that is a far enough gap that it's worth separating those two into two different categories. So whenever you hear somebody say, yes, this is good for 1440p, or no, it's not, it's important to know which 1440p we're talking about. Now, currently, there are no ultra-wide 4Ks. At some point, I'm sure we'll get them, but for now, we don't have any. So 5 million pixels, 1440p ultra-wide, yes, I would recommend this card if you have the budget. Now, the card below this, a 1080, will do that as well. But for the extra $200 or so you'll pay for this card, you'll be able to run your games a notch higher in detail, and it'll last you another year or so without having to either replace it or start turning details down. Please note that 1440p standard is closer to 1080p than it is to 4K. But 1440p ultra-wide is actually closer to 4K than it is to 1080p. So for ultra-wide 1440p, I do recommend this. For standard 1440p, a 1080 is enough if you're on a budget and you're looking to save some money. As a general rule, the more money you spend on your graphics card, the longer into the future you can wait before you upgrade it again. However, when you are in the rarefied air of $700 graphics cards, and let's be honest, this is not a volume seller. These cards are sold to premium buyers who want the best. 3 years from now, it's an entry-level card. Case in point, two generations ago, the GTX 780 Ti was a $700 graphics card 3.5 years ago when it came out. Today, a 3GB GTX 1060 for $175 beats it. Yeah. So in 3 years, don't be surprised when a $200 graphics card beats this. You're buying a limited period of time to have the best. This card is for people who plan to upgrade often. If you're looking to buy a card to keep for 5 years, well, frankly, the graphics card business doesn't work like that. Because if you had bought the mid-level graphics card 3 years ago, that can hardly play anything today, and $100 graphics cards often beat it. So the progress that we are seeing in graphics cards is still very, very rapid. This, for example, is a solid 70 to 80% faster than the card it replaced from just 2 years ago, which was the 980 Ti. It is dramatically faster than the 980 Ti. For those of you curious, I am gonna have an upcoming video series. I have already run the tests. I simply haven't uploaded them yet. 780 Ti versus 980 Ti versus 1080 Ti. I've tested several games on them and even I was a bit shocked at the results. I really expected the older cards to hold their own a little bit better than they did. But the truth of the matter is there is a massive performance difference between the various generations. So I've talked about 4K and I've talked about 1440p. What about 1080p? Is there any reason to consider spending $700 on a graphics card for standard 1080p gaming? Yes. However, most people shouldn't. They are the exception, not the rule. Most people should buy a 1060 or a 1070 for 1080p gaming. However, if you're the kind of person who says, I have to have ultra max detail on every single game, and I want ultra max detail on every single game released for the next year, okay, yeah, you actually will need a 1080 Ti, believe it or not. Ghost Recon Wildlands, believe it or not, does require a 1080 Ti for ultra detail gaming with everything turned up at 1080p. Now, that's a lot of money to spend for a couple of detail sliders, because let me be clear, a GTX 1060 will play Ghost Recon Wildlands at 60 frames per second at 1080p at high detail. You are spending triple the cost on the card for two notches of detail improvement. Ultra detail in many games is crushing. Bring the detail down one or two notches and you'll find that the performance improves dramatically. So a 1060 or 1070 is what I recommend for 1080p gaming, unless you have an ultra-wide screen, which is 2.7 instead of 2.0 million pixels. But I still wouldn't buy a 1080 Ti. The real deal is a 1070 or maybe a 1080 if you can find one in the 450 price range. For the 1080p resolution, those are going to be a better value for the money. There is one other exception at 1080p resolution to consider: high refresh rate gaming. Do you have one of the new 144Hz or even the new 240Hz panel from Acer? You might need this card, because if you want to go for up to or past 200 frames per second, you basically need all the performance you can buy, but you're spending a fortune to get it. Most games play very well on mid-level graphics cards at mid-level resolutions, at mid-level detail, without any issues, without spending anything close to this amount of money. But if you want the best, there it is. Normally, this is the part of the video where a bunch of benchmark charts come up and I start reading off a bunch of numbers to you, but we're not going to do that today. If you want to see benchmarks right now, the video linked below, which 1080 Ti should you buy? I tested multiple games and put multiple benchmark charts. You can check that out. There are timestamps in the video description in that video if you want to skip around. In this video, instead, what I'm going to tell you is about the upcoming videos I'll be doing with the 1080 Ti. I have two series, one of which I've already told you about, 780 Ti versus 980 Ti versus 1080 Ti. That one is going to examine how much has performance changed over the past three generations. The other series that I'm starting tomorrow is going to be 1070 versus 1080 versus 1080 Ti. I will test at different resolutions and different detail settings a variety of current games on a GTX 1070, 1080, and 1080 Ti, and I will put those together in videos so that you can see how much performance for the money do you get as you spend more. Currently, right now in May of 2017, when I'm filming this, you can buy a 1070 in the $350 price range, a 1080 in the $450 to $500 price range, and then these run about $700. Is it worth the money? Do you get enough performance to justify it? And how playable at what detail settings are current games? That's what that video series is going to be. Each video featuring a different game, because I'm actually going to show you real footage captured on each of the cards at the different quality settings so that you can decide for yourself what you really want to spend your money on. Thank you so much for watching. Like this video if you like it, share it with your friends if you loved it. Remember to subscribe to my channel with that big huge red button directly below the video. Questions and comments below the video, and as always, check out the links in the video description. Links to Amazon and Newegg for all the 1080 Ti's on the market. Please remember to use those when shop. I would greatly appreciate it. There will also be a link to my Patreon account down there. Please consider supporting my channel if you are able to. This was not a manufacturer sample from NVIDIA or from ASUS. I bought this myself. So if you like my channel and you want to support my independent reviews, please consider joining Patreon and contributing whatever you are able to. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you in my next video.